Have you ever wondered, why do rocket launches get delayed so frequently? Well, today we are learning about all of this and more with my super strong soda can experiment. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab some soda cans and the hand of a friend and get ready to be amazed. Emily's Science Lab, stay curious and keep exploring. If you've ever been to a rocket launch or followed one, you know that they get delayed all of the time. Why do they get delayed? Usually for a couple of reasons. There could be technical issues with the rocket, but more often than not, it's due to something simple. Wind. But how can a rocket that is designed to go 18,000 miles per hour and withstand over 3 G-forces be delayed due to a gust of wind? Rockets are designed to withstand vertical forces, not horizontal wind. And today we will learn about another object that is strong in only one direction. What you need for this one is simply a soda can and a friend to balance with, or a stand, or the edge of a table. So soda cans are very much like rockets, meaning they are only designed to withstand forces in one direction, vertically, not horizontally. Let me show you what I mean. Take your empty soda can, place it on the ground, and we are going to put 1 foot on top of this while we hold on to something. Now, parents and adults, this is mostly designed for kids. It may not work with adults, but you can try it too. Just be very careful. Put your foot on the soda can and then hop up in 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! Now, pick up your soda can and squeeze it in the horizontal direction like this. 1, 2, 3. Super easy, right? This can withstand all of my weight vertically, but it can't take a simple pinch from my fingers. Designed very much like a rocket. And this is why rockets that are designed to withstand 18,000 miles per hour can get delayed by a horizontal gust of wind. Thank you for learning about directional forces with me today. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.